What do you do when the day doesn't go well, as well as you expected? This video is a good example of that. Today was just a complete struggle. Couldn't get the traction today. But what do you do when that happens? Because it's going to happen to everyone. Not every day are you going to have just an incredible breakthroughs. So what you do is you maintain your patience, your resolve, and try to minimize how you get off track and how you try to overcompensate. And you just try and ride out the difficulty, really. Sometimes it happens, but it's not a complete washout today. And I'll tell you what happened to start the day off. Several things very important. I was awake, sort of dozing on and off, and I suddenly sort of had this impression, dream impression of someone sort of in the depths of my being, as it were, depth of field, deep, transmit rapid language to me and saying something to me in a burst of very, very succinct, clear phrases. And I couldn't quite understand what they were saying, but the gist of it was is that there is no survival problem. There is no survival crisis. There is no survival crisis. And this was what the practice of the day was supposed to be, but I spent all day trying to put this into some format, and I couldn't do it. I couldn't do it. It was very frustrating. There is no survival crisis. I understand what was being transmitted. There's some sort of transmission. It's sort of like a small person. It seemed like for me, like a Chinese or Tibetan Chinese type of person. Small, lightweight, not a big, robust person, actually, but very, very unassuming, dressed in just drab, nondescript clothing with a little cap on, I think, and just very, very, someone who you can tell is very comfortable being out of the picture, behind the scenes, quite interesting. The other important facet of this morning was I was aware of dreaming. I was aware of how the mind dreams. It sort of puts all the impressions that it gets in the day, and all these impressions it has, it puts them all together into a picture. Like say, okay, this is what we're experiencing. All these different facets. So you get this very strange, surrealistic, actually, dreams that were just like, what is all this stuff doing? It's just all these various impressions that you're collecting as you go about your day and hearing, and maybe stuff that we don't even realize is that we're getting, and our filters don't see it. We're not aware of it. And then the mind while sleeping tries to just fit it all into one picture and say that this is what's happening in your life. This is your life. It's like why dreams are so weird, you know. Because the stuff as we go about our day, we realize that there's you see somebody way over, you know, miles away, and somebody here and somebody over there in different situations. They're not connected as like one in one picture, but the dream puts them all into just like staging. This is just stage. That this is everything right here at the same time. Very odd. Very odd. We do not have a survival problem, which is very true. But I cannot find a way to put this adequately into words at this point in time. So, a day of frustration, but still, everything is fine. Everything is fine. Stay poised. Don't struggle too much. And see what you can make of the day. It's kind of like a down day, a down day. Now, Now, this advice, we don't have a survival problem, is very important, because it's the difference between succumbing and not succumbing. If we assert, I do not have a survival problem, I have a continuity problem. I do not have a survival problem, I have a continuity problem. This is key. I'm not sure how to work with this in a smooth way yet. I tried all day to figure out, how can I put things, I couldn't quite get it. So I just said, I don't have a survival problem, I have a continuity problem. And just repeated that over and over. I don't have a survival problem, I have a continuity problem. I don't have a survival problem, I have a continuity problem. And then you can talk about various crises. I don't have a stock market crash problem, I have a continuity problem. I don't have an asteroid hitting the earth problem, I have a continuity problem. I don't have a police state problem, I have a continuity problem. I don't have a martial law problem, I have a continuity problem. I don't have a dictatorship problem, I have a continuity problem. I don't have a global war problem, I have a continuity problem. I don't have a famine problem, I have a continuity problem. And you can go over all the crises that can come to mind, all the problems, crises, etc. You can even say, I don't have a cancer problem, I have a continuity problem. I don't have a death problem, I have a continuity problem. This is the root practice. So I went back to the root practice. When you're struggling to get more sophisticated, as I was today, you could go back to the root practice. And this is where your base is. This is how you center yourself. And this is where you tune in, begin tuning in to God, actually. As you say no to all these other problems, just no to them, and yes to the continuity problem, what you're doing is you're literally ascending. You're ascending as you do this basic practice. You're ascending out of problems. You're ascending into the continuity issue, which is solved by the Holy Spirit, resolved by the Holy Spirit perfectly, perfectly. So you're ascending into experiencing the remembrance of reality as it is. And leaving the problematical play, the play of problematicalness behind. That's what's taking place. So sometimes when you try to get real sophisticated and make, you get blocked for some reason, go back to the basic chords, go back to the basics, go back to the basics, which is what I finally had to do today. Maybe tomorrow I'll get it. There's some kind of difficulty there that I'm struggling with, of how to put this into the right format, so it's smooth and easy to practice. I do have a continuity problem, but I don't have a survival problem. My only problem is the continuity problem. Survival problem as it is now. Survival problem as it is now. Crisis as it is now. The location of survival problem doesn't matter. Survival problem as it is now. I don't have a survival problem. I have a continuity problem. The problem we have is with is now. As it is now. That's our problem. That's what we are struggling with and we're afraid of. So denying that we have a survival problem is very important. This is the transmission I got this morning. Denying that we have a survival problem is extremely important. You know, how we go about the form of denying that is a question. So maybe each one of you can come up with your own verbiage about it, your own declaration that that seems like a laser, very strong, powerful denial of survival problem. Survivability is not a problem. How could survivability be a problem for everywhereness? Where could it go to not survive? Our problem is we can't find anywhere to not survive, but we're in this world of, we've imagined this world where we're trying to not survive, and we've invented these cycles of bodies and stuff, so it makes it seem like we're not surviving, right? This is all like a fantasy, like a television show. Bodies incarnating, going, aging, dying, incarnating, going, oh, I'm not surviving. Oh, I died. You know, I didn't survive. Where can everywhereness go to not survive? Where can omnipresence go to not survive? So, we're playing this not able to survive game as if it were possible for God to die. But we don't have to keep playing that game, so we deny that survivability is a problem. I don't have a survivability problem. It's very powerful. I don't have a survivability problem. I don't have a survivability problem. This is powerful enough. I have a continuity problem. This is very powerful resonance. Maybe we don't need to get fancy with this at all. Just, I don't have a survivability problem. I don't have a survivability problem. I don't have a survivability problem. That declaration is aligning the mind with remembrance of reality. So these declarations are a way to align with remembrance. They're trending in that direction, trending in the direction of remembrance. Because reality doesn't have a survivability problem. Not at all. I don't have a survivability problem. And the reason why I push myself today and is really stressed out thing is that the problem with the world's coming up is the world is going to make a big old production saying to everybody, we here, the children of Mother Earth have a survivability problem, really bad survivability problem. Now, how are we going to struggle with this, and how's that going to work out, and blah, blah, blah. That's what the world is up to, is going to present a huge survivability problem to those who believe they have a survivability problem, or a survivability problem is possible, actually. So, we don't want to get suckered into that. So, what we do now is we affirm, I don't have a survivability problem. If others want to pretend they have one, you know, that's up to them, but I don't have a survivability problem. Now this brings in, what does this bring in? Into our experience. Certainly it brings in a different format, right, than what this world is presenting. So it brings in some what we call ascension in some broad terminology. I don't have a survivability problem. When you can accept this in your being, accept in your being, say, I accept that I don't have a survivability problem. I have a continuity problem, but I don't have a survivability problem. This is bound to be transformative, bound to be transformative. And it's the key, isn't it, to ascension. I don't have a survivability problem. You're basically saying goodbye to the survivability game, the survivor game. What do they call the show Survivor, you know, on some island? What is that island? The island is planet Earth. This planet Earth is the island where the survivor games are taking place. But in this instance, we vote ourselves off the island. We don't wait for someone else to vote us off. We vote ourselves off the island and say, I don't have a survivability problem. I don't have a survivor problem. I don't have a survivor problem. So I don't have a problem. My only problem is the continuity problem. So the issue of trying to survive is not an issue for us whatsoever. We do not have a survivor problem. Now things have suddenly shifted into some other space here. As they will do. I don't have a problem with survival. I have a continuity problem. I don't have a survival problem. I have a continuity problem. There you go. I don't have a survival problem. I was using survivor problem. Survival, not er. Okay, survival problem. I don't have a survival problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have a problem with survival. I have a continuity problem. I don't have a problem with survival. There you go. Got back in the groove there. I don't have a survival problem. I have a continuity problem. Just say this and focus just on this one statement. And keep saying it like you mean it. And insist upon it. Insist upon it for yourself. Insist upon it. Insist upon it. You can't force somebody else to insist upon it. But you can insist upon it for yourself. I don't have a survival problem. I do not have a survival problem. I have a continuity problem. It's like your ticket. A freedom from planet Earth, where the survival games take place. Everything here, this is like some kind of bizarre resort, planet Earth, where you come and play these survivor games. Everything is vulnerable and dangerous and tricky and treacherous, and it's like you've entered into some virtual reality, some video game virtual reality. And you think, wow, this is really stimulating and interesting, and this is incredible and weird, and freaks you out. But eventually you just say, wow, this is really not really what I really want to be experiencing. So you need to then say, I don't have a survival problem. I have a continuity problem. And you're basically exiting when you say that. But the exiting is an ascension, because you're not exiting via having a survival problem. No, it's because you're exiting because you say you don't have one. And probably you're pulling in this light, this grace, is coalescing around you somehow. I wouldn't be surprised if that happens. Portable paradise, you're pulling in a portable paradise. I don't have a survival problem. I have a continuity problem? Yes, absolutely, I do. I accept that entirely. Embrace it, accept it. That's my one and only problem. I don't have a survival problem at all. Very important to say, to insist upon this right now, because the world is again certain direction. And it's getting very treacherous territory right now. There are those who say that, the whole financial structure is going to unravel. I'm one of those who has been saying that for many years, actually, and have known about it since about 1998, as far as being shown very clearly what's going to happen. And when it unravels, it's going to unravel very fast. There are those who think it's going to unravel slowly. What I've seen is going to unravel with incredible speed and catch people by surprise. People think, oh, I have plenty of time to get my find the stocks, you know, and disinvest myself, you know, to dump my stocks and get into something safer. It'll be a gradual thing. I'll see it coming. No, absolutely not. The whole world is a pump and dump scheme, actually, it seems like to me. It's all a pump and dump scheme for the consolidation, ruination of fiat money, consolidation, and then eventually a digital currency. This is what many have foreseen, and I've foreseen this. And I say, well, the unraveling will happen with breathtaking speed. So this will bring up survival fears for everybody on the planet. But there are those who know that there are no survival problems. There is no problem with survival. Absolutely none. I don't have a survival problem. Those who have this, know this truth. Because where could we go to not survive in God? God is everywhereness. Everything is in it. There's no such thing as non-survival. It's ridiculous. But this attitude, this mindset, this perspective, this healed perception, can calm down the fears of the world. Again, even if someone's sitting in a cave, I think Ramana Maharshi said, there could be a perfect adept in the world just sitting in a cave, nobody even knows who they are, and yet they're having an immense beneficial effect on the entire planet. So I call the work crisis abatement, world crisis abatement, is to simply hold this thought form, hold this thought perspective of there is no survival problem. There is no survival problem. There's only a continuity problem. There is no survival problem. There's only a continuity problem. And to hold that clearly, you know, with complete awareness, is the best thing anyone can do for this world, actually. Because what happens is people will start being panicked and stampeded into thinking they have this terrible survival problem. And that will only exacerbate the entire situation. Of course, there are those who want to exacerbate the situation so they can use the crisis, never let a good crisis go to waste. They will want to, for people to then, feeling desperate survival problem, to latch onto them and worship. You know, worship someone who comes along and says, well, yeah, you've got a severe survival problem, but I have a very clever way I might be able to help you out here, and let's see if we can survive through this real difficult time, etc. And then you end up jumping into that boat and worshiping that and being submitting to that ideology. But the fact is, again, I don't have a survival problem. There is no survival problem. There is no survival problem whatsoever. None. We only have a continuity problem. That's what this transmission was this morning from this some adept, I would imagine, saying there is no survival problem. There is no survival problem. That's total delusion of the mind, mental delusion. And bodies are just acting out from this mental delusion. It's the mind in the state of delusion that causes the bodies to do what they do, even to die. Actually. Now, how come Ananda Maima died? Because she said she was simply going along with the wishes of the world. It just says, you know, you want this body to act, to go through the phases, cycles, phases that you go through. So She said, it doesn't matter to me what happens to the body. Whether he lives or dies, there's absolutely no difference. She said, no difference whatsoever, because never identified within the slightest bit. So if you want to see this body get old and die, okay, that's what you're going to see. So, and there are other adepts that don't die, actually. Physically don't die. The body stays young. That's possible, absolutely. Because it's all in the mind. The mind that knows there is no death, there is no survival problem whatsoever. And that could be the case. And their body may even turn into a light body, too, you know. That's very possible. So ascension could be your body starts turning into a light body. That is possible. You start to somehow there's this coalescence of this light. But simply saying there is no survival problem. There is no survival problem. Survival problem. Spaciousness as it is now. So survival problem spaciousness as it is now. Survival problem spaciousness as it is now. If we're saying I got this survival problem, okay, say survival problem spaciousness. Always use the term spaciousness because that's an accurate statement. Survival problem spaciousness as it is now. Meaning survival problem spaciousness is spaciousness. It's not something other than spaciousness. So does spaciousness have a survival problem? Spaciousness is spaciousness. How could it have a survival problem? Does what appears, does decorations, crystals, imaginary crystallizations in spaciousness, is that causing spaciousness to have a survival problem? Is a cloud appearing in the sky and then disappearing? Is the sky have a survival problem? So, survival problem spaciousness, as it is now. It's the nowness of spaciousness, of pure spaciousness. It is the nowness of pure spaciousness. All is the nowness of pure spaciousness. So where is there a survival problem? I don't have a survival problem, I have a continuity problem. Very simple, very simple, very simple. Now maybe I tried to make it too sophisticated. I said, wow, you know, this is such an important one. I need to really pump it up. No, maybe not. Just say, I don't have a survival problem. I have a continuity problem. Survival problem, spaciousness as it is now. As it is now. This is now. This is now. This is now. Survival problem, spaciousness is now. Survival problem spaciousness is now. You could say survival problem consciousness. Some people use the term consciousness. I tend not to, but survival problem consciousness is now. I don't have a survival problem. I have a continuity problem. What consciousness is not now? Is there some consciousness that's not now? Time consciousness is now. Survival problem consciousness is now. Death consciousness is now. There's only now. So how could now have a survival problem? And if there's only now, where's the problem? There's only now, and now doesn't have a survival problem, so where's the problem? There isn't any. So I don't have a survival problem, I have a continuity problem. And the continuity problem is that we believed we have a survival problem for so long, we're afraid to be without it. You say, oh, I need some problem. If you can't give me a survival problem, at least give me some problem. Give me the potential to have a survival problem, even though I don't have one. You say, okay, and the Holy Spirit says, fine, that's the remedy. But at least the potential to have a survival problem still faintly present, or plausible, but not actual. Not actual. Resolves the continuity issue. So, I don't have a survival problem, I have a continuity problem. I don't have a survival problem. So, survival problem, spaciousness, is now. Survival problem, spaciousness, is now. Survival problem, spaciousness, as it is now. So whatever it is, as it is now. Whatever it is, whatever my state of mind you find yourself in, right as it is now. That is now. That state of mind is now. And when we don't realize that, we're likely in a coma. In a coma, we're very much unaware of what's going on outside of us, only very vague and fuzzy, right? We wake from a coma, and then we see, oh, there's all this stuff going on that I was unaware of. So we are, all our thoughts, when are those happening? They're happening right now. We have a thought about a survival problem, thought, where is that thought? When is it? It's right now. How? As it is. And exactly as it is. Exactly as it is now. Survival problem, spaciousness, thoughts as it is. As it thought, as it is now. Survival problem, spaciousness is now. I don't have a survival problem, I have a continuity problem. This is key. This is like the root now of pragmatism as far as going forward, as we head into the next week. I said that this next week, I said by Lincoln's birthday, the 12th. I said that, you know, quite some time ago. Well, I had a dream that showed me, and I tried to pinpoint when will this happen. I figured it's sometime, like from the 10th to the 12th, sometime in there, you know, in that area, Lincoln's the 12th, somewhere around there, I saw the wheels coming off, and bad crash. So we'll see what happens if it's this year or just exactly. It's hard to pinpoint things in dreams as far as dates go, that is for sure. But survival problems, people will think they have severe survival problems. So we have to go one way or the other. So we're going to go one way or the other. So we might as well say, I don't have a survival problem. I have a continuity problem. Don't just say, I don't have a survival problem. The ego then will still have leverage over you, because the ego says, well, if you don't have a survival problem, I guess you don't have any problems, so I'm going to take all problems away. And you say, no, that's too quick, I don't like that. And the ego say, well, then you're stuck with survival problems. So you have to say, I don't have a survival problem, I have a continuity problem. So even if you're filled with light and you know surrounded with light, you still say, well, that's fine, I have a continuity problem. I don't have a survival problem, but I have a continuity problem. And I'm just, you know, I need to remember reality as it is. So you stay centered, grounded. Whatever happens, whatever mystical, miraculous, whatever happens for you, you just stay grounded and say, well, this is just part of the remembrance of reality, so. It's just part of the journey now. That's all. Just part of the journey. And certainly, I've decided I don't have a survival problem. I have a continuity problem. And just abide in that. Just rest in that. Just abide in that. That's all. I don't have a survival problem. That's it. Plain and simple. I have a continuity problem. Now, those who have the consciousness, they're saying, I have a survival problem. Of course, they're screaming for help, 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 help. But whatever you believe in and value, that is what you will be experiencing. So if you believe in and value and you say, yeah, I do have a survival problem, then you will have survival problems. It doesn't matter how many times you're rescued. It doesn't matter who comes in and rescues you. You'll then have, you'll have another survival problem after that, and after that, and after that, and on and on and on and on, endlessly until you decide, I don't have a survival problem, I have a continuity problem. So the game of trying to help people, it doesn't really work that way. It only works by showing them how to truly free themselves from this delusion of having a survival problem. Same with the suffering problem, sickness problem. It's all vulnerability problem. Someone who gets sick, who believes in sickness and values sickness and feels it's a way to protect themselves from abruptly going back to reality, abruptly awakening to reality, you have one cancer, they cut it out, you get another one, you get this sickness, you get that sickness, the doctors are working, you get all this medicine, it keeps coming, and no matter what you do, it keeps coming, keeps coming, keeps coming. Always you will find yourself on a trail of tears, a trail of problems. And you think that the answer is to solve the problems. Yeah. No, you're still valuing and believing in problems. It doesn't matter what you think you solve, you'll get another problem, for sure. The way out is to say, I don't have a problem. I don't have a survival problem. Say, I don't have a survival problem. I have a continuity problem. And just say, that's it. I don't have one. I just don't have it. I don't have it. Meaning, there's no value to it. I don't believe in it. There's no value to it. And therefore, I'm saying, I don't have it. I don't have it. And the truth is, I really don't have it in the first place because I only have a continuity problem. Otherwise, I would wake up immediately and realize there is no problem. It's impossible to have a survival problem. Totally impossible. So, if something's totally impossible, we don't have it in the first place. When we say, I don't have a survival problem, you're saying, I'm no longer believing in what isn't there. That's what we're really saying. I decide I'm no longer going to believe, no longer going to believe in what isn't there in the first place. So, I don't have a survival problem, I have a continuity problem. Anyone can do this anywhere, right? You don't have to be sitting in a Himalayan cave. Anyone, wherever you are, you say, I don't have a survival problem. I have a continuity problem. Wherever you are. And so, to round out this video, the benefit of keeping your cool during a day when you just don't quite feel you're getting it. I still don't quite feel I'm getting it, but you just hang in there. You just hang in there. It's like catching your breath. Maybe you're out of breath. Just catch your breath. And still try. Maybe tomorrow I'll have some unfoldment of this. We can say, I don't have a reality problem, I have a continuity problem. We think we have a problem with reality. Now put the problem where it belongs, on the continuity issue between dreams and reality. I don't have a survival problem. There is no survival problem. Survival problem, spaciousness, as it is now. See, survival problem, spaciousness, as it is now, covers every possible thought of survival. All survival problem spaciousness thoughts, the spaciousness, it covers all of those. So problem, survival problem, spaciousness, as it is now. I don't have a survival problem. I have a continuity problem. There is no survival. survival problem as spaciousness as it is now. There is no survival problem. Survival problem is spaciousness as it is now. Is now, which is spaciousness, is now. This is now, spaciousness is now. Pure spaciousness is now. It's always now. Everything is always now. All is now. Now is now. Now is now. Now is now. There you go. Now is now. And that puts it into the right context right there. Now is now. Nothing else needs to be said after that. Now is now. All right, that was it. That now I feel a lot better. To get to that, get to this. Now is now, and today. So today's been a success. You see, it was a failure up to this point, and suddenly, the breakthrough right at the end of the day. Right at the end of the day, just before bed, you get the big breakthrough. Now is now. In. That's an awesome statement. Now is now, and what acceptance there. So, very great. That's how it's done. You hang in there, and you keep on trying. Don't get frustrated. Maintain your mood of repentance. Stay sober. Stay humble. Say, okay, just got to be patient here. Just going through a little struggle here, a little struggle. And it's just keep in mind, it's because you're trying to get to a higher understanding. So you're struggling a little bit. And maybe I was trying, how do I, say now is now without saying now is now? And finally I realized, let's just say now is now. It seems too simple, right? So how can I say that in a sophisticated way? Well, it's all about simplicity. So, extremely profound statement is now is now. Now is now. That's what we've been denying. We've been denying that. We've just been denying that now is now. That's all we've been doing. So all we need to do is just state now is now. The great realizers, what are they doing? They're just abiding in now is now. That's all. So we can do that too. There's no reason why we can't. Now is now. And we actually need to abide in that coming up for sure. All right. Now is now. Very great. Very great. Well, Hate to wrap this up because this is really something, but if the mind can be captured, attracted to this now is now, then you're in a good place. You're in a good place. Very good place, actually. Very auspicious. And let's see how it goes from here. All right, that's it.